The quality is not guaranteed. You can think that what we are eating is truly Italian while it's been done in China or somewhere else. That's why I didn't mention, but there is a very, very important agreement ongoing under negotiation between Europe as a whole and the United States called the TTIP, Trade Investment Transatlantic Agreement, something like that, that should be signed probably within next year. And this treaty should be opening the greatest free trade area of the world between 350 million inhabitants of Europe and 300 million of United States. This, of course, means that our products, the French products, the Spanish or the American, could freely go up and down from different reality of the Atlantic Ocean, but must be also protected. Because otherwise, you have, I don't know, the Italian Chianti wine done in California, but without the region, or the champagne made somewhere else. So this is a very important task, and probably if this agreement will be signed and concluded, we expect to have an increase in economic relation between the Atlantic, very strong, bring an economic growth of all the areas concerned, including Florida, where the relation with the European countries are very strong. Just to say, end of this month, we have the Fort Lauderdale show, which is very important. Maybe many of you, you go there to see the boat you would like to buy or whatever. 80% of our export goes to America, and the Italian production in maritime industry are the most important, the most prestigious in the world. Many big cruise shipping that are docked in Miami Beach, the harbor of Miami, are done in Italy, in Trieste, in Livorno, in Cantieri. They supply boats to Carnival, to Mediterranean Shipping Company. So if you think that the market could be open completely, the relation, economic relation between the two realities would increase, and also the employment. Talking about visiting Italy, of course, there is a big flux of Italian or American going to Italy, but as it is normal, the objective of the visit is a short period, 1 week, maybe through cruise shipping vacations, and we may visit Venice, Florence, Siena, maybe Sicily if we have the time, etc. Not knowing that, as the commentary is shown in 15 minutes, you have so many realities that the greater majority of the foreign tourists, even the Italian tourists, don't know, they've never been there, and there are great realities. For example, in 2019, Matera, which was the city shown at the end of the movie, in the southern part of Italy, will be proclaimed the cultural city of Italy for this European project, in order to open this reality to the rest of Europe, in order to be open to visit. And another point very important for us is from May to October, I think, or to the end of the 6 months period, it will be open in Milan, which is the center of the economy of Italy, the World Expo, which is an expo open to 150 countries, including America, and it will be showing the sustainability of the food, feeding planet, all the aspects of, having an healthy approach to food. And it's a very important occasion because Milan expects to be visited by almost 30 million people.
Yeah, and talking about food, since the topic interests you so much, apparently, you know that here we're talking about fast food, but in Italy there is a slow food movement. Not only in Italy now, you can find it all over the world, but the slow food movement, it's the archenemy of the fast food. So what does it mean? That you have to take your time. You have to have your lunch or your dinner seated, not in front of the computer and definitely not in front of the TV. And, you know, relax, talk with your family, talk with your friends, It's like a kind of spiritual experience when you're eating in Italy. And what you should do also, you know, now that you start studying the culture and the language, it's something that you may want to try when you're here as well. When you go out with your friends in an Italian restaurant, where of course we know that the pronunciation is bruschetta and not bouchara, or spaghetti and not spaghetti. So we do know, right, how to recognize a real Italian restaurant now. So you may wanna, you know, try the slow kind of enjoying a meal with your family and your friend, like in Italy we do, no? the Italian way. And what else? Well, food, of course, and food and food. But also, as the General Consul said, we have 20 regions. Each region is very small, and such a beauty, treasures that are there, undiscovered, not very well known abroad, such as Matera, I Sassi di Matera. It's a beautiful, amazing place to visit, and very few people know about it abroad. But just like Matera, there are so other many places that you really, I mean, I also have to discover because I've never been there. They were talking about Molise. I don't know the Molise region at all, for instance. So also knowing a culture and, you know, be blessed and have the opportunity to visit a foreign country, especially to visit Italy, it's really an experience that it will change your mind. I know what are you thinking. Yes, but you are Italian. Of course you have to say something like this. No. No, because yes, I'm Italian. When I was in Italy, I have to be honest with you guys, I didn't appreciate what I had. In order, I started to appreciate Italy, and I really agree with the General Consul, it's the most beautiful place to visit on vacation, when I was abroad, when I started to live in here. I travel a lot, I travel different countries, but still, not because I'm Italian, but I still believe that it's the most beautiful place because it gives you so much in so little time. You can have it so much in so little time, and you can go from the north to the south in really half a day if you want to, or even 45 minutes if you take a flight. So go if you can. And of course, start studying the language. I keep going, studying the language.
If you want to discover Italy, you can start also from Miami, because the second biggest Italian community in the States after New York is Miami. We have a very, very, very big community. And in America as a whole, there is another community which is American, but has a very, very strong relation with Italy, which are the Italian Americans, become something like 20 million Italian Americans in the United States, mainly concentrated in the northeastern part of the United States, New York, Philadelphia, Boston, Chicago, because of course at the time the migration of the Italian where the economy was, Florida was not the case for you to be here for migration. So there is a very big Italian-American community. Got to say that the mayor of New York, the new one, is Mr. De Blasio, of Italian origin. When I was posted in New York at the time, at the consulate, the mayor of the time was Giuliani. Just to tell you the strong presence in New York of the Italian-Italian-Americans. And here we have a very, very growing community. We count last year 20% more Italians residing in the area of Miami in respect to the other year, the previous year. And for example, not all of us know that the mayor of Doral is Venezuelan, but is also Italian, to say.
You were talking about firma. I would like you to say a little bit about the companies that we have here in Miami, some renowned companies, Italian companies.
You mean activities, economy?
Yes.
We are very strong, as I said before, in the maritime industry. We have Ferretti, we have Azimut, both in Miami and Fort Lauderdale. We have a very, very strong presence as far as the design is concerned. If you go to the design district of Miami, portion of the houses of design are Italians. we have, of course, food and wine imports and restaurants, which are a very important sector. We have also technology, because there are two big companies in Southern Condotte, USA, that are Italian companies based in America. They are participating in construction of roads, bridges in the area for loading, also in the airport for loading in Miami area. We have the cruise shipping industry with a big base based in Bahamas, where there are the shipyards. We have fashion, of course, Gucci, famous, Ferragamo, and so on. And we have an Italian, a strong Italian presence growing, investing in Miami, buying properties, buying activities, buying joint ventures. And we have culture. And this presence has been formally recognized last May, May 1st, by the Senate of the state of Florida. I was there in Tallahassee because the Senate approved officially a resolution proclaiming October 2014 and forever Italian and Italian-American Heritage Month in Florida. That's why this October we are organizing, we organized especially last week, 2 weeks ago, many events in Miami based also on cultural aspects. And if you have the time, you can go to Wynwood, I think, on 29th Street. There is a street art workshop, work of graffiti artist, the most famous graffiti artist in Italy, who was given a very large space in order to perform a huge Statue of Liberty
Michelangelo David, no? Yeah. David of Michelangelo. And the other side, the pictures is incredible. Maybe I can enter to see if it's possible to show the picture. Because it's very well done. It's very nice.